this is H.C. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy IV! Let's go collect some more of the weapons at the Cave of Trials. First things first, we want to equip Yang with the Ice Claws, and maybe not necessarily unfortunately, but we have to bring Edward into the front row. The reason is because the Apollo's Harp, I don't know if it's a bug or not, but it doesn't deal full damage from the back row, or rather, his hit percentage is cut in half. It's not considered a long-range weapon for whatever reason. I'm guessing it's a bug. But it's not so big of a problem because, look, he's got a ton of defense multipliers and great base defense and magic defense. So even with his low HP, he'll be fine. So don't worry about putting him in the front row. He'll be good to go. Let's show him the power of the Spoony Bard! For boss time! This is the Storm Dragon. Obviously considered a dragon-type enemy, but also he's weak to ice! So that's why I got the Ice Claws on Yang there. Now, the only thing with Edward's Harp, the Apollo's Harp, is that it is... well, it's fire elemental, and the Storm Dragon is resistant to fire. Wow, look at that damage with that harp there! Holy cow! And he is resistant to fire. Imagine if he was not resistant to it. Edward can deal near max damage to dragons if they don't resist fire. So, unfortunately, this one does, but it's still totally worth it. So, basically, you got Ice Claws on Yang, the Apollo's Harp on Edward, Lazaga from Rydia. We should be good to go. Once you get double spider silks on him, that's pretty much all you need to worry about. You don't even need a dedicated healer. That's why I didn't bring Rosa or Porom along. Whatever you've got with Edward and Yang, you can just kill these guys so fast. And that's the thing with Yang and Edward particularly, is that their speed is so high that the only way to really take advantage of it, because you can only answer in your commands so quickly, or whatever, you need the Berserk to really take advantage of it. So anyway, Yang has, 87 strength, 41 speed, 64 stamina. He's already got plus 5 from the Cat Claws of Strength and Agility. Give him that. It's also Holy Elemental. Look at that. Yeah! Woohoo! He's got plus 15 strength, speed, and stamina with that. It's ridiculous. So, okay, let's bring Edward back to the back row there. Oh, and I should probably heal up too. Let's see, Cid I want back on the Gaia Hammer, Yang back on the Lightning, Lightning Claws. Heal up and we should be good to go. That doesn't really look like a hammer, but, well, I'll take what I can get. For boss time! Okay, first things first, Bacchus Wine on Yang. This boss is considered a machine-type enemy, so that's why I've got the Lightning Claws to deal quadruple damage to him. Same thing with the Gaia Hammer, that deals quadruple damage to machine-types. We'll get double spider silk on him, and we should be good to go. Obviously, Edward, not going to be too useful in this fight, so he's Boxwine there. So maybe get Bahamut going, we should be good. He's got wires coming out of his mouth and his ears and everything. Holy cow. I wonder how salve would work considering I don't have any potions. Wonder if it would just use high potions or something. Well, let's use it. Why not? Let's see what happens. I've never done this before. Edward Salve Command? Still not that great. Final Fantasy IV The After Years? That's a different story. But we'll get to that soon enough, viewers. Yeah, Yang is just so amazing with his claws, and... But I didn't have a potion. How does that even work? Well, whatever. Just let Yang do his stuff. But yeah, Yang is just so powerful, so fast, so versatile. He's one of my favorite characters in the game. So, yeah, I love having him in my party long term. But for defeating him, we get the Thor's Hammer. Alright. So let's check that out. He's got 63 strength. Guy Hammer already gives him plus 5. So Thor's hammer. Yeah, well, look at that attack power. 220. I mean, compared to 189 from Cecil. And he gets plus 15 strength. So that really helps him out a lot. His speed is just still too low to be of any real use. So, okay, well, that's everything I can do here. We got two more weapons to go for. And I'm going to rearrange my parties I have listed in the video description. And then I'll just meet you on back here with my new party then. Okay, we're back. And I've got Palom and Porom with me and some other characters who I thought would be useful here. But before going for their weapons, there's another enemy that I want to meet up with around here that I couldn't defeat before. The Golden Toad. So first things first, I want to use a silver hourglass on them, or any hourglass, it doesn't matter. I want to stop him before it's too late. How does Palom... Oh, right. It's like, how does Palom have such good speed? He has the Sage's Robe, which gives him plus 10 speed. But anyway, in order to kill this guy quickly enough, I want to use Tornado on him, and then just whack him upside the head. There we go. The reason I want to use Tornado and stop on him is because, if I recall correctly, if you don't kill him quickly enough, he'll just run away. So, okay, well, that was easy enough. Let's see, I want to go for this one first. Yeah, I better take care of the frog status. Sword in the stone, apparently. Oh, hey, no. Down. There we go. Oh, I forgot I had Porom with me. I guess I don't need to worry about that. Okay, for this one, let's give Edge the Mage Masher and the Moonring Blade. And yeah, we should be good to go. I hope this boss doesn't whack Palom upside the head as hard as Porom does. Now, in this version of the game, you can actually target the Flan Master. In the Game Boy Advance version, there's a bug that, for whatever reason, you can't target the Flan Master without taking out some of his monsters with him. So, if you're playing the Game Boy Advance version, you need to use multi-targeting attacks like Bahamut, Quake. Maybe I could even use Meteor. I've already learned it for Palom, but that just takes way too long to charge up. Do I have a rise? I should. I don't. Okay. Never mind. Carry on. Good thing I got all these things with me. Go. Maybe I should have equipped him with... I'm trying to think of something that resists lightning. A Luminous Robe. But I suppose the Flan Master can do whatever he wants. Use a different element. Good thing I got the Robe of Lords on Porom. Now, the Flan Master is considered a mage-type enemy, which is the primary reason why I brought Edge along, to be able to take advantage of that. Otherwise, yeah, like I said, you'd have to use Quake, Bahamut, and that's pretty much it. The Flans, you really don't need to worry about. You just need spells that can get around... Reflect. Nice. And I need Edge to stay alive if I can. Help me, Edge, you're my only hope. You know, I'm not even gonna bother healing him up all the way. If they deal enough damage to kill him, it's going to be a lot more than his maximum HP anyway. Hooray! We got him. And for defeating them, we get the Triton's Dagger, Palom's ultimate weapon. So let's see, he's got 83 intellect. Let's see, replace that. He's got 88, so it gives him plus 15 intellect, because the fairy rod already gave him 10 there. So, alright. And before this next one, you want to cast Float on everyone. And yeah, I think that's all we need to worry about. Let's see, Edge, let's go back on the Moonring Blade and Kiku-ichimonji. Okay. Last one. Looks like a rod, but I think it's a staff for Porom. Ah, whatever. Alright, it's boss time! Jurassic Park boss time! Now with this guy, let's see. I want to use the same thing as before, because I think he has an auto-reflect on him, if I recall correctly, or something like that. Let's see. Or he counterattacks. I don't know exactly. For some reason, I just have it in my notes to use Quake, or Quake and Bahamut. I forget exactly why. But, whatever. Okay, he doesn't have auto reflect. It must be a counterattack thing that he does or something. Like I said, I'm not as familiar with this part of the game as I am other parts, so... Oh well. Yeah, I know Bahamut's awesome and all, but... I'd rather just fast forward to the spell animation. Thanks. Yeah, for some reason, he doesn't counterattack Quake and Bahamut, or things that would bypass Reflect. I don't know why. Got me on that one. I could have used Edward here. I think he is. Or maybe he's not. No, I don't think he is considered Dragon-type enemy. Okay, never mind. Carry on, guys. I could use Sylph, I suppose, if I really cared about keeping myself healed, but... Nah, I don't think that's necessary. Oh, Cecil, you can join in on the fun, too. You don't have to just stand there. I know you're not as cool as or powerful as the Spoony Bard now, but you can chip in. It's okay. All you got is a sword. He's got that badass harp and everything. Yeah, unfortunately, I can't put Edge in the back row for this party. I figured Rydia is very useful for her summons, so I really wanted to bring her along instead of another melee fighter. Ow. Let's see. Kiraga. There you go. How does she summon Bahamut all the way here anyway? I mean, the guy's all the way on the moon. Must be using a lot of his frequent flyer miles every time we summon him. Yeah, melee fighters are not going to deal too much damage. He doesn't have any elemental weaknesses or anything else that I can exploit, so... Yeah, this is probably one of the harder ones that you can deal with, or you have to deal with eventually. Is that dragon on fire? Not anymore. But anyway, for defeating him, we get Seraphim's Mace, or Seraphim, whatever. It's Porom's ultimate weapon. So, let's give that to her. Let's see, she's got 78 spirit. Aura staff gives plus 10. Now she has 83, so it's plus 15 spirit for her. So, that's pretty nice for her. Okay, well that's everything that we can do here in the Cave of Trials. Who will I bring with me to the moon? Find out next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy IV! This is HC Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!